because you did do these things, don't take for granted that everything happened just then. You know, I hear a lot of people saying, oh, it's finished. No, you're still undone. You still got an unclean spirit that still got to, yeah. You bringing that, it's already done. You're not Jesus. You're not Jesus. You're not Yeshua. Why are you thinking it's already done for you? No, you got some things to go through. And that's what it takes to go through with the forbearing patience. Amen? Yeah. So then when that patience come upon you in everything, and then you can have the joy. When Yeshua Jesus went down in the pool when John the Baptist, the immerser, baptized him, what did the Father come and say? My beloved Son, whom I'm well pleased. He was well pleased with his Son. We want him to be well pleased with what we're thinking we're attempting to do. Even if we don't know, we will do it. Because Father, I know you're well pleased that I even got a mind to want to do it today.
Yes.
That you committed the work to my hands, to the thought life, and you've established the thoughts that you called me to. Just thinking about his glory. Just thinking about his goodness. Remember we used to always hear that in the church? Oh, when I think about his goodness. Oh, I just, my soul. Why do you think they didn't say, oh, my life? They said soul, because the Bible says a man's soul, if he sins, he shall surely die. So you got to go to the soul. Eternal life is yours to have.
Yes.
And when we have eternal life, that's the one new man. That's the one new man. The saints have the light of life living in them.
Amen.
Through them. It's no more. It's all about what I did. It's not about what I want to do. It's about your will, Father. Your will be done. No more.
Amen.
I don't care. It's not even about other people, because other people are weak and feeble.
Yeah.
They growing to a wax cold mentality about everything. You're insensitized about what's going on around you. It don't matter because it hasn't affected you yet. Yes. And he's saying that he wants his people redeemed. The forgiveness of sin.
Hallelujah.
The forgiveness of sin.
Hallelujah.
We look at what's in it for us a lot of times, but the forgiveness of sin.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. I'm not going to be before
Hallelujah.
You, but I just want to keep
Hallelujah.
Reminding you that the message that he would have me to say, because it pleased the
Hallelujah.
Father. And why it pleased the Father is to have to make all the fullness dwell.
Hallelujah.
All the fullness dwell through him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And through him to reconcile all things. All the fullness through him. And then to reconcile all things to him. Because he made peace through the blood of his cross.
Hallelujah.
Through him, whether they be the things upon the earth or the things
Hallelujah.
In heaven.
Amen.
I feel so good when I think about the wholeness.
Hallelujah.
The wholeness and the healthiness of a life that's saved. In the things, in the fear of Yahweh, the wisdom that comes upon us because we have been put and begotten by him. We've let ourselves, let our sins go and traded masters. When we came out of Egypt, we didn't come out of Egypt just because he wanted to bring us from keeping from dying. We came out to serve and worship him. We came out to be his people. He wanted to put us in another place where he could be our master. Again, because it pleased the Father to make all fullness through. that you love him and you can call, you can go according to his purpose. You're a free man. You're one new man. Hallelujah. You're one new man. You don't have the same struggle you had last year. You wouldn't beat down the walls about something that your mama did, that your daddy did, that your sister did, that your brother did. But now you're one new man.
Yes.
Hallelujah. 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 Come on, give him some praise. Because the mysteries that have been hiding, the hidden away mysteries of the ages are now unfolding. The hidden mysteries of the ages are now unfolding right before our eyes.
Yes.
And we have to contend with our faith to understand what he's going to do in this day, in this hour, in this season.
Yeah.
We've got to understand that we can't afford to get by anymore from generation to generation.
Yeah.
But now it's been revealed to who? It's been revealed to the saints.
Yeah.
It's been revealed to the saints, to whom God desired to make known among the heathens the wealth of the glory and the mystery which is in Messiah, in you, the hope of glory.
Amen.
The hope of glory.
Amen.
When he comes back with his reward, he's going to be the hope of glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Which we are proclaiming, admonishing everyone, and teaching everyone in all wisdom, that so we will present every person complete. Complete. In which I toil. This is Paul still speaking.
Mm-hmm.
Toiling according to his working, that worketh in the power. The work is in the power. Can I get you to say, the work is in the power?
The work is in the power.
Not the power over the work, but the work is in the power. That work is in the power. That's why you've got to commit this day, everything, known and unknown. That's a complete surrender to his will being done, that you would please the Father. And after he got through dealing with the congregation and letting them know what he was sacrificing and how he was living, letting himself be used for their benefit, the fullness of life came for the congregation.